Hey there, hunters. I'm going to do something a bit different today with this video. I'm going to go over common complaints, nerfs, buffs, and things Capcom can fix on in the short term to make Monster Hunter World better. I haven't been very vocal about how I feel about World because it really doesn't matter, but after talking to some people, I feel like I should address at least some things in hopes that Capcom will fix them. Special thanks to Rainy and other members of the Discord for reading my rants and pitching in. Let's start with what's kind of OP and needs a nerf. Nerfs that should happen. Rocksteady Mantle. This mantle is broken. You can literally ignore the monster the entire time it's active. It's also a build enabler for setups that just kind of sit still and spam the same move over and over again. Now, I don't want this nerfed into the ground like Slicing Shots was. I just want one change to it. Either remove the defense bonus it grants, or reduce any one factor of the Rocksteady part. Make it not negate all hits, or maybe not even all tremors. Or roars from Elder Dragons, something. Just change any one thing about it and turn that dial down from a 10 to a 9 and it'll probably be fine. Let's see how it goes. Evasion Mantle. Evasion Mantle is more broken than Rocksteady. Yeah, you heard me. Who needs to ignore everything when you can just avoid it all and get a 30% boost to your raw damage? This mantle needs to get changed from boosting raw to affinity. Then bam, problem solved. With current builds having mostly max critical hits and critical boost, this mantle pushes your damage into just insane levels. Swapping it to affinity will let us remake builds with less crit and still provide good boosts with the evasion window and extra crit chance. Cluster 3s. As it currently sits, cluster spam is just dumb. It takes no skill and you literally just stand still and fire clusters until a monster dies. Okay, so if you nerf Rocksteady, this build is going to be dead anyway because you won't be able to reliably sit still and rain clusters all day, but cluster 3s still do a ton of damage. Just reduce the damage by like 10% and call it a day. It's not a ton, but enough that you probably couldn't kill monsters with cluster 3s alone without some good RNG from that Xeno gear. Aerial attacks. Bow wall jump is, as everyone knows, insanely strong. The motion value is 3 times higher than any other attack save for Dragon Pierce, but it's spammable in the right situations. Drop the motion value to 27 instead of 35, and we're good. For melee, a recent surge of ledge jump spam has trivialized a lot of fights. There needs to be some sort of change here to make it less spammable. Something like consuming more stamina and preventing stamina regen for a second or two. It's not going to hurt any normal gameplay, but it should prevent spamming aerial attacks indefinitely. Alright, let's go over buffs. Bowguns. I'm biased, of course, as a gunner main, but bowguns still kinda suck. In previous games, light bowgun and heavy bowgun had raw modifiers of 1.3 and 1.5 respectively. These are gone in World, which is why they both deal the same damage. The only difference is the clip size and recoil levels of the guns. But the real issue with bowguns is that most bowguns need to stock up on full recoil or reload mods just to shoot ammo effectively. These aren't skills anymore, so we can't just gem them in on a set like we used to. If they can adjust the recoil and reload levels of most MOs, then heavy bowgun will be much better. For light bowgun, rapid fire is just wonky. If you can move in rapid fire, currently it doesn't matter since the bolts all go to where the initial shot went. Yeah, think about that one. If they change it so that it fires and moves with you, and maybe increase the rate of fire for rapid fire, then light bowgun will be much better off. Also with light bowgun, they need to adjust the explosion levels of Wyvern Blast. If you didn't know, there are 3 different explosion levels for the blast, which determine the damage and the amount of explosions it can proc. Now unfortunately, these thresholds are so low that almost everything will proc the final tier of explosion, which also happens to be the least optimal. Let's just move these thresholds up a bit so you don't always proc the heaviest explosion. Bows. Fix the spread shot issue. That is it. Currently, firing a spread shot and having the arrows fly straight up into the air instead of hitting the target is just dumb as shit. This affects light bowgun and heavy bowgun as well, but I haven't noticed it as much. It's of course having the issue with the camera and targeting angles of this game. When you're aiming at something and it quickly moves in front of you, the arrows will want to go to the reticle but have no angle to do so, so they end up firing straight up and out of the way. It gets really annoying really fast. Gunlance. Shelling is almost pointless. It eats up too much sharpness and it's just not that strong. Reduce the sharpness cost of full burst just a bit and buff the damage of Wyvern Stake by like 10% or so and let's see how that plays out. Charge Blade. Please buff Elemental Discharge. Not the impact files, just the Elemental. They are such trash that there's only one good charge blade to use, which is Diablo's. Nothing else gets used. Please buff elemental charge blades. Here's a buff for the monsters. Solo monster stagger thresholds. Can we please get a little bit of a higher threshold for monster staggers in single player? Solo consists of stun locking a monster to death, and it can be done with almost every weapon reliably. It's just really boring. The life isn't the issue here, it's really just the staggers. Don't make them multiplayer level, but bump them by like 30% or something so we can't just stun lock monsters to death, as I had done in the Kushala video with the heavy bowgun. Tempered monsters. These are just plain dumb. They hit harder, but that's all. There's nothing special about them. I forget monsters are tempered half the times because you're not supposed to get hit, and if you do get hit, you're probably dead. Make these monsters crazy, like frenzied monsters or ferocious monsters from the previous games. Make them do something besides just hit harder. And then here are other things that aren't directly nerfs and buffs related, but really should get changed. The canteen. Dude, the canteen system sucks. You cannot reliably eat for any food skill or even max life if you want to. I miss the old canteen system from 4U and Gen where you could almost always get the skills you want and life at the same time. It wasn't just another RNG element to the game. If we take the time to create a special meal with the proper ingredients, can we please get at least one of the skills that we selected? Don't even get me started on the freshness thing. I can't tell you how many times I try to eat for attack up large and I get less than 30 extra HP. It's just making me consume more max pots at the start of a hunt, and it's just a nuisance at this point. Skill adjustments. Raise your hand if you run weakness exploit, maximum might, or critical boost on your set. What's that? Everyone raise their hand? Z, there's an issue there. Can we get some skill rebalances? The vast majority of skills are just trash, and we need to nerf the ones that are just OP. Weakness exploit needs to go to its 4U form, where it just adds 5 to a hit zone, rather than 50% affinity. Crit boost is actually fine, it's kinda hard to fit on a set anyway, and maximum might needs to drop down to 7%, 14%, and 21% extra affinity. It's not that much, but trust me, it'll make a difference. Tempered investigations. This is also an issue, albeit a smaller one. Farming for investigations is just kind of a pain in the ass. Everyone stalks tempered dragons around, and it's really not a secret, it's just the optimal way to do it. But can we just get a set of weekly events that include an HR 50 tempered elder dragon, an HR 30 quest, and like an HR 13 plus quest, just so everyone has access to some form of tempered investigations? Nobody likes chasing Kirin or Nergigante around for an hour to get like 2 investigations. Special arena quests. After you capture a monster, you gain access to the special arena quest to hunt that monster in the arena. But after that quest, it goes on a random cycle like advanced quests in previous Monster Hunter games. All I really have to say is, why? Can we just do them whenever we want, please? And the Gathering Hall. We all know no one uses the Gathering Hall. Can we just have players share the world space of Astera, please? Is that really that hard? That's all I currently have. Bigger things like new monsters, maps, and equipment is not something I expect them to add short term, so that's gonna be saved for another day. Unfortunately, I'm not exactly a Blade Master person, so I can't speak for all the Blade Master weapons. I'm sure there's things that need to get changed, like status weapons and sharpness for most of the weapons. I know there's only one or two good weapons for all the weapon types. Anyway, that's all for me. Thanks for listening, and good luck out there, hunters.